All right, guys, let's have an open discussion before we start this review. I see a trend with manufacturers for a while now where they design kits which are supposed to make life of installers easier. But from my perspective, it honestly not makes the life of installers easier, but more towards the end user. So it's more like a marketing scheme where it's like, here's four cameras and an NVR, you can do it yourself. And yeah, not the biggest fan here, but we will still do a review about this following kit today. And honestly, leave a comment below if you feel that kits are maybe not the most optimal thing for installation. And when I say this, I mean that there's no flexibility. So you have four of the same camera. So it's not ideal on my end. It's also more for small projects. So when you install in a residential setting, and most of the time you need more than four cameras. So it's maybe more for renting a place, an apartment, stuff like that. And again, not the most optimal choice. And that's about kit, but now it's about Wi-Fi kits too. So Wi-Fi kits, and another trend that I'm not a big fan of, is Wi-Fi can work great in some settings, but again, when we're talking residential side of things, when you try to install cameras and it's four of the same cameras, well, they cannot be perfect in every side of a house, of an apartment. So you always need this flexibility where you choose a camera for, let's say for outside. So you maybe want some kind of a night color technology. You maybe want a higher resolution. Okay, I'm rambling around. So let's start the review. I will open this kit right now. All right, guys, we went on to open the box and this is what you have inside. So we're talking about four power supplies for the camera. So you have 12 volts power supply that will go directly in the camera. You have a power supply for your NVR. Again, another 12 volt. You have all the bolts for the cameras to set them up. A nice little small mouse for the NVR. Four cameras and your Wi-Fi NVR. We're talking about a 1 terabyte Wi-Fi NVR. So the hard drive is already installed, the NVR itself. It has a 280 meter range for the Wi-Fi signal. Here we have 2 megapixels bullet cameras. Normally the antennas, they come underneath, so you have to screw them inside the camera. As you can see right there, it's not a long process. It goes by pretty fast. So this is what's inside the kit with your quick guide. Again, I think this kind of shows what I was saying earlier about the flexibility of kits, in the sense that kits are more for small projects and you have four bullet cameras. More specifically for Wi-Fi bullet cameras. So bullet cameras are normally installed for outside settings. But with the Wi-Fi connection, I don't feel like it's the ideal scenario, simply because with a Wi-Fi connection, you can have your smart TV on your Wi-Fi connection, your computer, your phones, and now you're adding four more cameras outside, so the signal has to go through walls for the connection. It will affect the performance of your cameras. That means any kind of motion, the FPS, so low drop rate of your frames, it can be a problem in the long run. But now let's get to the connection and let's wire them up. The connections are almost done. So let me show you what we have in the back. So first off, you have a VGA port if you don't have an HDMI connection on your monitor, but we have one. So we use the HDMI port right there. Following that, you have two USB ports where we put the mouse that we find inside the box. If you have a keyboard, you can also plug it in, so it will be easier for you to input your password. Then the Cat5 for your internet connection. And as you can see right there, underneath the antenna, you have your 12-volt DC port, and this is how we're gonna power up the NVR right now. So let's get to it. You will hear a small noise, and that means that the NVR is working. Now let's turn on the monitor and see what's going on. If it's your first time installing a UNV kit or NVR, anything like this, remember that you always have a quick guide that comes with your cameras or NVR. Inside, you will have the default password to power up the NVR and to enter the video management system. You have also all the IP details if you want to connect to a web browser. So don't be shy. If you have questions, just go and take a look inside. Everything is there. All right. So now we need to enter the password. Like I said before, if you have a keyboard, it's much easier. Default password for UNV is 123456. There you go. Now we won't change the password right now, but always put a more secure password, please. It's about security, so there's no shame in doing something complicated. All right, I like doing the pattern Zorro. So then you have to input after the numerical password. You draw it again. Then you will receive this prompt. This is when, if you want to use the UNV application to download onto your phone, and then you will be able to see your cameras. We will do a video about this later on, so check out our channel, it's coming up. When this is done, next, you have your time zone. And don't neglect this part, guys. For analytics, having the right time zone is essential. That's one of the main problems people find, is that when you don't have the right time zone, the analytic doesn't work. There's kind of a time lapse problem that happens there. So make sure it's the right time there. And if you don't see the right time zone here, you can actually modify it in the settings later on. Here you have your default IP address and your Wi-Fi settings. Right, and you switch to the recommended resolution, et voila, there you have it. So as you can see, it's really, really easy to set up. All you need to do is plug in everything inside your NVR, so it will send the Wi-Fi signal to the cameras, and as you can see, they're all connected already. As you can see, we have our four separate camera right there. As you can see, they all have a different screen. And as you know, it's an 8-channel NVR, so you can add up to 4 more cameras, whether they are dome, bullets, turrets, they just need to be Wi-Fi, and this is how you would do the connection. Now, this went perfectly. UNV does a good job with this, but if for some reason your camera didn't connect directly to the NVR, you can actually go inside the menu, and in the camera here, in the menu of the NVR, you would see all the cameras that are in range of the NVR. By default, their IP are all in range of the NVR IP, so that shouldn't be a problem. But if it is, you would go inside there and you would be able to see the missing camera and add it manually. Now, I also mentioned that it has a range of 280 meters, but if you are doing an installation in open space, you can actually create a Wi-Fi cascade. What that means is that you're creating some sort of repeater between each camera so you can increase the distance of your Wi-Fi connection. To do this, inside the VMS itself, you go inside Network, you click on Wi-Fi AP. Once you've clicked on Wi-Fi AP, on the top you see Wi-Fi Cascade, and this is where you would drag and drop a camera to create a cascade. So you create a Wi-Fi repeater up to 3 camera. As you can see, if I try to add another one, it won't work. And this will create a longer distance for your Wi-Fi connection. All right, guys, so today we've seen kits. I know some of you were interested about UNV cameras, the software, but I think it's important for installers and manufacturers to understand maybe opinions of what we think about certain projects that they create. Again, I think kits and Wi-Fi kits in general are more of a marketing scheme to encourage end user on buying their own kits and installing them themselves, rather than having a professional installer do the right job, because it's not easy even though they are Wi-Fi. If you agree with me, you can say it in the comment. If you disagree, I would love to hear your opinion on this too, because I think it's important for us to talk about the real things. And this is what this video was about, because as you can see, the setup itself is really easy. I simply plugged in all the wires inside the NVR, and all 4 cameras of the different cameras on the table, they went live. So yes, it's a good product. Yes, it works well in this setup, but on a real life project, there can be some complication. Again, if you are a professional installer, a professional manufacturer, and you would like us to review or discuss some topic that you find important to talk about, leave a comment below and we will see you on the next one. Yeah.